see you, I see you.
All these girls in the club, I got my eyes on you. All these girls in the club, I got my eyes on you. All these girls in the club, I got my
we're gonna start off by chopping our sausage. You're gonna see me chop up some scallion. I added parsley, thyme, and scallion in a bowl. Next, we're gonna put some olive oil inside of a pot. I don't know the exact measurements. I'll let you guys know in a few, but we're gonna let that fry up for a little bit, and then we're gonna add in our green seasoning. The green seasoning I make myself. If you guys want, I can give you the recipe for that. Just let me know. So as you can see, I'm dropping it in a pot, and we're just gonna let that cook down for a little bit so it can flavor up the oil. So my oil was a little too hot, so I had to go in and reduce the heat. Just a FYI, because it will start burning a little bit, and that's when I noticed maybe I should turn the heat down. I just had it on high because I wanted to make sure my oil was hot. After about 5 minutes on medium low heat, you add in your sausage and you begin to let that fry. I let my sausage fry for about, I can say, 7 minutes. Once I began frying my sausage, I began to turn up the heat to medium high to make sure that my sausage is frying appropriately and correctly. After frying for about 7 minutes on medium high heat, I began to remove the sausage out of the pot, and I'm gonna put it somewhere separate because we're gonna add the sausage back in soon, but we're gonna use that same oil to fry up our veggies. You'll see that coming soon. At this point, I still have my stove on medium high, but once I add my veggies in, I'm gonna reduce it down to just medium because I don't want my veggies to burn. I want it to steam nicely and evenly because we're gonna use all of that goodness. Once you add in your veggies, you're gonna give it a good stir because you want it to saute very nicely. As I'm doing here, you'll see me just keep on mixing, and I keep doing that for a few minutes. After that, I let it sit for about 5 minutes, and you'll see that it becomes very translucent. Thank you. then go on 1 tablespoon of minced garlic. The reason why I didn't add the garlic in the same time that I did the vegetables is because I did not want the garlic to burn. I wanted to make sure everything sauteed first and then added in the garlic to give it that extra nice boost of flavor. Once you add the garlic in, you're gonna let that saute for a few minutes to boost in that flavor and lock in that flavor. After about 5 minutes, I start adding in my seasonings. I'll have everything linked in the description bar below so you can see exactly what I use, and I also will have the measurements down there for you. After you add in your seasonings, you then start to mix and you let that saute just for a little bit as well, because you want the flavors to actually come in and combine as one to boost up its own unique flavor. When you are mixing at this point, you want to turn your stove down just a little bit more. If you have the numbers on your stove, I would say like a number 4. And the reason why I say that is because we have all of these dry seasonings and barely oil inside of the pot, because the oil soaked up in the veggies, and you don't want the seasonings to really burn at the bottom. It's no problem if it does burn at the bottom, because we're going to go on with liquid anyway, but I just want to make sure that it doesn't burn too early. I then go in with 2 cups of washed jasmine rice, and once I have that rice in, I'm going to start to toast the rice a little bit. At this point, I turn my stove up a little bit more, so right now it's at a 6. I don't have the numbers on my stove, but I pretty much know the numbers without seeing them. You are then going to go in with 2.5 cups of chicken broth. The reason why I use 2.5 cups is because I actually like my jambalaya pretty wet. I don't really like mine dry, but if you prefer yours dry, you can go in with 1.5 cups if that works for you. But it's pretty much up to your preference. Our rice starts boiling inside of that good chicken broth. We add in 3 bay leaves, and then we go in with a little bit of crushed tomatoes. However, I use a little too much, but it's no issue. Just don't use as much as I use. Once you do that, you're going to start mixing up your rice and let everything combine, and you're going to let that simmer for about, I can say, 3 minutes. We add back in our sausage that we previously fried, and once that's all in incorporated, you're going to give it a good mix, and that's when we begin to let our slow process begin. We then drop our thyme leaves in. At this point, you reduce your heat to about a 2 or 3, and then you cover. Once you cover, you allow your rice to sit for about 15 minutes before you check it again. Once you check it, your rice should look like this, and then you want to go in and mix it to make sure nothing is sticking to the bottom. You want to repeat this process a few times, I can say about every 5 to 10 minutes. Once you check your rice, make sure you are covering it back so it can steam nicely, and once it's done, it should look like this. Hope you guys enjoyed this simple one pot recipe. Let me know how it tastes. Also, make sure you like, comment, and subscribe. We are on our way to 1,000 subscribers, and I think I'm gonna try to upload every Sunday recipes. I'm not too sure yet, but thanks for tuning in. Bye.
High volume.
Am I really that?